There's the lawyer and the lecturer. Then there's Alan Young, the activist, an unconventional man in a conventional career and one of Canada's most fierce cannabis crusaders.
There's a certain frivolity to this issue, so there's a tendency for people to think, oh, Alan Young, yes, he's a very good pot lawyer, but God forbid you should put him in court to do any other type of case.
Alan Young's resume reads like a best-selling novel. He's defended Toronto area dominatrix Terry Jean Bedford on charges of running a common body house. He's fought for the rights of the critically ill to use medicinal marijuana. He's even successfully argued an obscenity case involving a music video by the 80s rap band 2 Live Crew. Sex, drugs, and rock and roll. A far cry from the hallowed halls of Osgood. But it didn't start out that way.
How does a respected lawyer and law professor cross over into the world of defending pot and pot users? For Alan Young, it took one case in particular, a case that would change the course of his professional and personal life for good.
The year was 1985, the height of the Just Say No to Drugs movement. It was also the year that now CBC journalist Robert Rosie Robotham would receive an unprecedented sentence for conspiracy to traffic hashish. It was then that Alan Young knew Canada's drug laws had to change.
Rosie, I think, received 18 years. My client received 14 years. I had been doing some crimes against the person before that, and they were receiving 2 years, 3 years. I couldn't understand the disparity, and I thought I should try to do something about it. I only started to do something about it when I had the luxury of becoming an academic and having too much time on my hands so I could become a troublemaker.
I met Alan in the early 80s, and he stood out even as a young lawyer. He was a very, very bright, knew the law, and he knew he was a rising star right from the very first time I met him.
Rosie Robotham says what other lawyers only talk about, Alan Young actually does, simply because he's so passionate about the issue.
A lot of the times he does it pro bono, and because he knows that the laws, his feelings of the laws of marijuana are unjust, and he's doing what he can to make a difference. So he can look in the mirror and live with himself.
Bruce Ryan knows that generosity firsthand. The co-founder of Section 56 Compassion Club has received Young's pro bono legal advice on numerous occasions, proof to him that his first impression of Alan Young was right on the money.
When I first met Alan, I actually walked up to him and I said, you don't look like a lawyer. And he began to laugh and said that this was one of the highest compliments I could pay him.
It was that type of activist zeal which rubbed some in the legal profession the wrong way, but not Osgood Hall colleague and fellow lawyer Bruce Ryder.
He's a passionate person. He's has a brilliant legal mind, and he's got great advocacy skills. And put all that together, and you have a powerful legal activist.
As colorful in his constitutional crusades as he was on campus, Alan Young didn't quite fit the professorial mold either.
So he used the vernacular. I think all the students thought he was just whacked right out.
Paul Burstein is one of Alan Young's former law students, now a lawyer himself. He says Young made an impact on him and a huge contribution to Canadian civil liberties.
We often joke, him and I, that if he ever were going to maintain a law practice, that his card would say specializing in sex, drugs, and rock and roll. And indeed, many of his cases have dealt with the civil liberties issues dealing with those topics.
But Alan Young couldn't bring the pot issue to the courts until the time was right, the late 1990s. That's when he saw the tide turning, not in legal circles, but on primetime television.
I started noticing a lot of references to marijuana, funny ones on The Simpsons about smells from Otto's jacket and things of that nature. When I could see that American network television would allow a more jocular marijuana perspective, I knew the time was ripe.
And Alan Young waded in. By 1995, Young had successfully challenged the prohibition of drug literature in Canada. By the late 1990s, he'd kept 25 marijuana cultivators out of jail and successfully poked holes in the government's medical marijuana program. The court gave Ottawa until July of this year to distribute marijuana to authorized Canadians. Now, with the pot decriminalization issue before Parliament, Alan Young should be happy and hopeful. but he's cautious.
Marijuana activists who have been around for a while will tell you there's no reason to get excited until legislation is actually passed. It's taken them a year to introduce this bill. This government has a limited lifespan. Gretchen will step down February 2004, Parliament will dissolve, this bill will die on the order paper. That's my opinion.
For the first time in a long time, Alan Young is watching all of this from the sidelines. He's not teaching or practicing law. He's taken a year off to write a book, a scathing expose of the legal world and his detractors. For News World Today, I'm Kara Wiest in Toronto.